I'll welcome in the series of AWS Solution Architect Certification Exam Dumb. So out of 300 questions, I'm in the next question that is related to that auto scaling. And it is the most frequent question coming keep on coming into the associate certification exam. So let's jump on the question. So question says a call center application consists of a three-tier application using the auto scaling groups to automatically scale the resources as needed. User report that every morning at 9 a.m. the system becomes very slow for about 15 minutes. A solution architect determined that a large percentage of the call center staff start work at the 9 a.m. So auto scaling does not have enough time to scale out to meet the demand. So let's highlight the hint here. So I'm highlighting the time, that is the 9 a.m. And another unit, it is auto scaling group. We need to manage the three-tier application into the auto scaling group so that it will be scaled automatically. So there are the two hints here that 9 a.m. we are getting the high traffic, means like very slow in the sense like we are having the high IOPS is being happens and most of the users are accessing the application at the 9 a.m. So you can see that there is a correlation auto scaling group at a certain time. So I will just try to mark it as an arrow here. And now I am jumping to the question that how can the architect fix the problem? So I'm jumping on the answer. First is the change the auto scaling group scale out event to scale based on the network utilization. Yes, that could be a correct answer, but here it is trying to say like that if suppose at the 9 a.m. your auto scaling group is trying to scale out, then it is required some time to warm up the new EC2 instances and mapping with the load balancer. It will take some time on the basis of the network utilization, but the thing is like that it is hardly you are having a time window for 15 minutes. So in this 15 minutes, even though if you are going with the scale out concept for the scaling group, then it will take some time to attach the new EC2 instances, warming up the EC2 instances and configuring with the elastic load balancer. So it will take some time. So even though in this answer, you will get some latency and it will be slow down in this initially 10 to 15 minute duration. So I will mark it as wrong because we need to make sure that in this duration it should not be slow down. Next, create an auto scaling scheduled action to scale out the necessary resource at 8:30 a.m. every morning. So here you can see like that, okay, we are scaling up, means like we are adding the more instances at 8:30 a.m. so that 9 a.m. if anybody is logging, he will not face any latency, it will not be slow, he will not face any performance issue. So I will go ahead with this answer. So this answer is the correct answer. And you just need to know that what is the scheduled action. So basically in the auto scaling we are having a concept, we can time based we can do the scheduled action. We can say like that I am pretty sure about that 9 a.m. there will be high traffic, so before that, half an hour before that, I want to make sure that I am having the more instances on the basis of that traffic network. I will predetermine and I will add few more instances so that 9 a.m. there will not be any traffic issue. And before 8:30, I am not paying any cost for the new EC2 instances. So basically cost wise, it is very good. And we are paying money for just for the usage based. However, it is just 30 minutes before we are warming up the instances. See, I'm just jumping on the next answer just to evaluate. Use reserve instances to ensure the system has reserved the right amount of capacity for the scale up the event. So this is the wrong answer. Basically, reserved instances are you are paying for the 1 year, and this is not the good answer for such kind of scenario. Basically, here you are just going with the on-demand concept and you are paying for the use basis. So reserved instances we can't use at all here. Now I'm jumping to the answer D, permanently keep a steady state of instance that is needed at the 9 a.m. to guarantee available resources but leveraging the spot instance. This is the wrong answer. It is trying to confuse you, because when we are using the auto scaling group, just we can go with the schedule action. Just I need these many EC2 instances available at the 9 a.m. So I am doing the scheduled action at 8:30 a.m. and it is gonna to work. So the B is the correct answer. So I'm jumping on the more explanation on it. So there are the main pillars of the auto scaling. It set up the scaling quickly, that is true. But here, if suppose you are scaling up at the 9 a.m., if I'm going with the option A, it will take some time. So still the user will face some performance issues in the initial 5 to 10 minutes. Quickly, it is not like we are talking about 1 millisecond or 2 millisecond. It will take some time. But yes, it can scale up, but it will take some time. Make a smart scaling decision. So this is depends upon that user, how they are choosing the scaling policies. It should be scheduled scaling, or it should be the based on that high traffic, which is undetermined. For an example, that you launched your application and suddenly you are facing some performance issues at 10 a.m., 11 a.m., something like that. So you can use that dynamic scaling, and initially for 5 minutes, user will face the issues, but it will scale up. And automatically maintenance, performance, yes, AWS take care about all these things. So you no need to worry how the performance we need to maintain, because auto scaling is the managed service by the AWS. Pay only for what you need. So that is the good thing. And you need to keep in mind that if you are auto scaling policies, you are adopting it properly, then you are paying on the usage based only, and automatically it will remove the instance which are not being used when the traffic is very low. Jumping on the another slides, like how the auto scaling works. So here you can see like that, okay, explore your applications, discover what you can scale. So mainly generally we go for that EC2 instances, where if it is based on the microservices, then it is good. We can determine that these microservices are being used frequently by the users, and those EC2 instances, you can deploy into the EC2 instances and provide that dynamically scaling here. And as well as, yes, you can go for that databases for higher read and write without any performance issues. You can also choose database for auto scaling, and choose what to optimize. Yes, cost. So basically, just we spoken about that if you are pretty sure about that 9 a.m. you are having the higher traffic, so just go for the scheduled scaling here. And it also minimize the cost. If suppose performance traffic is very less, in that conditions it automatically remove the EC2 instances, so you no need to pay the cost for that so many number of the EC2 instances. And track scaling at it happen, that I will describe it through the next slide. So here you need to make sure that launch configuration, where you are defining what will be my AMI, the name of launch configuration, instances type, you must have to be pretty sure that, okay, compute service will be high, so you can go with the C kind of instances. And key pair is nothing but it is related to the EC2 instances, user data, security group, and the IAM role. So mostly it is good if you are adopting the same security group, so that you no need to again and again map with the database. For if your application server is accessing the databases, so then make sure that you are having the same security group and IAM role is assigned with it. Auto scaling, then you are jumping on the auto scaling group. Once launch configuration is done, then it needs the name, launch configuration details, and multi-availability zone if you are having, our private public subnet, how many min max capacity you can define. So for an example, if it is very high traffic but you do not want to scale out for the higher instances because of the cost, then you can define that, okay, cut it like 4 instances you want to use, even though users are facing some traffic problem, but I don't want to pay more cost because revenue is very less. So you can adopt the max capacity you can define. Desired capacity, you can define it there. Load balancer is nothing but the ELB. And metrics health check is actually auto scaling also having feature that it check the health of EC2 instances. For an example, when EC2 instances, it trying to attach it, but it is not being, it is not running properly, then it will try for the another EC2 instances. So auto scaling having some kind of features which automatically check the health of EC2 instances. After that, you are having a scheduled action. Scheduled action help define rules to perform the scaling action at a certain time in the future. So it is depend upon that when you want to attach the EC2 instance, which EC2 instance that is already defined to the launch configuration. So the scheduled actions will happen. It is related to that when you are attaching the EC2 instance at what time, when we want to attach it. And then next is the auto scaling policy. Auto scaling policy helps defining rules for dynamic increasing and decreasing the EC2 instances. So this one basically it is related to that if suppose traffic is very less and already you spin up multiple EC2 instances, so dynamically it will decrease, you no need to do any kind of work. So hope you are liking my tutorials. If you are having any doubt or having any question, please write in the comments. Thanks a lot.